This is an example of using a measured residence time distribution and the idea of segregated flow to calculate what the conversion would be in a reactor system with that residence time distribution. So showing here this residence time distribution, E of T, and it's represented by the green line. So it's a simplified residence time distribution in order to make the calculations easier and see the behavior. And I've tried to indicate a grid of dashed lines on the graphs because one of the things we have to do is put a scale on this in order to apply the idea of residence time distribution to conversion. So we want to know the conversion of A for a second order reaction, where we have a feed concentration of A and we have the rate constant of A. So the first thing we have to do is understand what we mean by E of T. So it's worth writing down the definition to make this clear. So here is what we mean by E of T. So E of T times DT, looking at some sliver in this diagram, represents the fraction of fluid that's exiting reactor that has spent the time between T and T plus DT in the reactor. And so E of T DT, if we integrate from 0 to infinity, all these fractions should add up to 1. And of course, we're going to take advantage of this now to put a scale on the plot that's given. And we'll do this in a very simplified way by just looking at the plot. And so I can look at the area, and if this has some scale that we're trying to determine, call it A, then one of these cubes is 5A. There's three of them, so 3 times 5A has to equal 1. So A is 1/15, and the unit's minus 1, so units of time, universe is inverse time, the area then would be dimensionless. So I can replace A here by 1/15 and indicate here that the units are minutes to the minus 1. So now I can use that residence time distribution and the information from the reaction rate and segregated flow. And so what's meant by segregated flow is we can imagine packets moving through the reactor, like little batch reactors flowing through, and they spend different amounts of time, which is indicated by, of course, the green plot here. And then we're going to collect at the end all these packets to determine the average conversion. So that means each packet, we need to know how much reaction takes place if it spends a certain amount of time in the reactor. So we're going to, for segregated flow, we're envisioning we have a large number of batch reactors that are moving through the system and having certain amounts of time to react. And so we need to do a mass balance for a constant volume batch reactor. It's a second order reaction. The rate constant was 0.2, concentration of A, and this is a fairly standard calculation. And so we can separate variables, and we can integrate from 0 to some time t, which would correspond to a concentration at outlet of Ca and the starting concentration of Ca0. So if we integrate and substitute in 1.5 moles per liter for Ca0 and simplify. So the integration is shown here with the limits, and we rearrange to give the concentration of A as a function of time in this batch reactor. So now what we want to do is use this idea of the residence time distribution and segregated flow to calculate the average concentration leaving the reactor, and we'll use this notation. We're going to integrate in general over all times the concentration of A, which is a function of time, times how long each of these little batch reactors have to react, the residence time distribution. And so if we go back and look at our plot of the residence time distribution, the function is zero everywhere except from 5 to 10 and 10 to 15. From 5 to 10, its value is 2 15ths. 10 to 15, its value is 1 15th. And so we can just integrate over those two ranges because 5 to 10 minutes, its value is 2 15ths. And then we have the concentration as a function of time, dt. And then from 10 to 15, its value is 1 15th. So we can do the integration to get the log expression. And this will end up being first term, 2 15ths. So I've substituted in the numbers here for the integration. And then using these limits, get the average concentration leaving this reactor, assuming segregated flow. So if we want the conversion, it's the inlet concentration minus, in this case, the average outlet concentration. And this is 1.5 minus 0.419 over 1.5. So the conversion, 72% of the feed is converted in a system with this residence time distribution.